Namaste. Welcome to Southern International. Today we are preparing wonderful dish which is called chicken dum biryani. Most of the Indians like this dish, but generally we have a fear when we go to a restaurant. Most of the kids and our family members really they enjoy this biryani. They enjoy the flavor, they enjoy the spiciness in the biryani. Generally we feel it is very difficult to prepare this biryani. But today I'll show you a simple method where what are the ingredients available at your home. You can prepare with all those ingredients. Very simple technique. Happily you can enjoy restaurant biryani at your dining room in your house. Let's see all the ingredients what we are adding to this biryani. And now I'm going to show you all the ingredients. Most of the houses, they have a problem with the vessel, for preparation of biryani. But here, I have taken a very small vessel. It's a non-stick one. So, you have a lid for this. So, with this vessel, you can prepare excellent restaurant-style dum biryani. And let's start the preparation. Marination is very important for preparation of this biryani. And I'm showing you marination part. I have taken 1 kg of chicken. As I told you, take this kind of a bowl. I added chicken into this, the 1 kg of chicken. Now I am adding all the ingredients to this. I'm adding dhania powder. Jeera. I added near about 2 spoons to this. And it is a very small spoon, like your tea or coffee, generally use this kind of a spoon. You can use this. Little bit turmeric powder. I'm adding ginger and garlic paste. Adding chili powder. Generally Indians, they eat spicy biryani. And salt is required. And if you want more delicious biryani, I'm adding butter to this. Then if you have butter in your home, you can add that, or else you can get Amul butter and you can add this Amul butter to this. I'm adding little bit Shah Jeera, few chilies. You should not forget to add garam masala, a lot of lemon juice to this. Even you have a lot of C vitamin in this lemon. Now I am mixing all the ingredients. Now we have to add curd, nice sweet curd we are adding to this mixture. See, I added 1 kg of chicken and this is almost 1/4 liter of curd. If you want, you can add more. If you want more gravy, you can add more. And now I am adding coriander and mint leaves. And finally, you can add little bit oil to this. If you want, you can add ghee, but today I'm adding oil. So completely, we added all the ingredients. Now it is done. So we have to keep it aside for half an hour to 45 minutes. The reason behind that, the total chicken will get this spiciness into it, will absorb total spices to that. When you're eating biryani, the chicken will be very tasty. So you have to keep it for some time. If you have a refrigerator, you can keep inside that, or else you can leave it aside. So this chicken, see, the total marination is there for the chicken. And I put little bit dots to this. It'll absorb the total spiciness to this. And no doubt, this will be definitely like a restaurant biryani and everyone will enjoy it. Now, we need to go for the second preparation. We need to boil the rice and we should add to this. So I'm keeping this chicken chicken aside, I'm covering it and I'm keeping it aside. Now this is the second process. We have taken a steel bowl with the water. Once the water is boiled, you need to add ingredients to this. See, I have bay leaf, I have elaichi, dalchin, and all the star anise and all the spices. I'm adding to this water and little bit shajira and 2 to 3 chilies to this. A little bit ginger and garlic paste, so the flavor, rice will absorb the flavor. No need to add more. And finally, salt. See, most of the people will prepare biryani, but the problem is definitely the salt will be more or salt will be less. Here, when you are boiling the rice, you have to add exactly the salt to this, and the taste should be like a sea water. See, when you go for the beach, generally you feel very saltiness to the when you taste the sea water. So exactly the taste should be like that. Need to add soaked rice. Here we have the rice. Almost 1 hour we soaked this. I'm adding 1/2 kg of rice to this. The water is completely boiled. So now I'm adding rice. This is soaked rice. Okay, biryani always we see layers, you know, the flavor comes from the layers and it comes from the chicken. So almost a rice is 80% cooked, 70 to 80% cooked. So the first layer should be 75% cooked, and second layer 85%, and third layer 90%. So then automatically when you're giving steam to the dish, automatically the bottom layer will cook more and the top layer will cook less. So when you're adding the rice, generally what we do, we cook 90% and we add the rice. So if that is the case, the bottom rice will get very softened and it will be difficult for eating. So here the rice should be always flaky, and when you're giving the steam, it will cook. See, now it is almost 75% done. I'm adding the first layer. So I have taken first layer, I'm adding it. So I added this and I have to wait for another 2 minutes. So we'll get 85% cooked rice. Okay, the rice is 85% cooked now. So I'm adding the second layer to this. Now it is almost done, around 90% of rice is cooked, so I'm adding that as a top layer. Now the final preparation, we boil the rice 75%, 85% and 90%, three layers we arranged in this. And topping, these are nicely golden fried onions, and you can prepare at your home or you can get it from the market also, but I prepared this directly here. You know, nice flavor. So I'm adding. See, here you need to take one precaution. If you make it black, automatically biryani will become bitter, so it doesn't taste good. So please remember, it has to be in golden brown in color. So I added the onion to this, and our Indian traditional butter ghee biryani, you'll get lot of flavor out of this ghee. I'm adding ghee to this. Already we added butter in the marination. Finally topping, I'm adding ghee and coriander. And required mint leaves. And little bit you can add saffron if you have, or you can add little bit yellowish color. Because our people always depends, you know, we like only the colorful dishes in India. So I'm adding little bit, or you can add saffron if you have it. you know, I added milk into this and little bit color to this, or you can add milk and saffron and you can make the color and you can add it. So now almost done. Now only thing is we need to pack this. See, I have the lid, I'm covering it, but generally when you're cooking you'll get steam from this part, from this corner. So we have to cover this. So I have taken atta dough. Generally we have you can add refined flour or you can add atta also to this. Generally every home will have atta, what we prepare chapatis with it, and that you can fill this with that particular dough. You can fill this. So here we have atta prepared, the dough, and now I'm filling this. Generally you fill for the both corners, then automatically steam will not come out. You know, dum biryani, the total preparation is 50% and the steaming is 50%. It is very much important. If the steam comes out, generally the rice should absorb the flavor, and when you're eating you'll get that flavor exactly. So that is what the biryani is. And generally we fail in this last preparation. Generally steam will come out and we cannot give nice flavored biryani. Even for mutton also the same preparation, for chicken also same preparation, even for the prawns, all dum biryanis same preparation. You know, one more secret ingredients I'll tell you at last, wait for it. I filled it with atta dough completely. You will not get any steam outside, and now the cooking time is exactly 20 minutes. Don't leave it for longer time because the chicken will get burned. So 20 to 22 minutes exactly. So first 5 minutes on a high flame, later on you just decrease the flame on 4 sides. You just spare the time. So 20 to 22 minutes your biryani will get cooked, and see you after 22 minutes. Now I'm just added, and we need to just move this to the all four corners, and after 22 minutes let's take it out. So now the preparation is done. So we removed the plate and see the fragrances. So very nice. Now I'm taking out the biryani. See the color. Wow, it's looking awesome. And here I am adding chicken piece. So after wonderful presentation, definitely we couldn't able to wait. No, we have to taste it. So I'll tell you the taste. It is looking very delicious. Really awesome. And let me have the chicken piece also. It's very soft. Really, very nice.